Get ready to match the stars. Stu Gilliam. Loretta Swit. McLean Stevenson. Brett Somers. Richard Dawson. And Ann Elder. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And here's the host of Match Game 73.
There. Johnny Olson. Ladies, thank you very much. We've got some, we welcome all of you people who've been here with us many times before, and we've got new blood that we'd like to welcome, McLean and Ann. We thank you for joining us here today.
Thank you, and may I say the new hairpiece looks very well, Gene.
I love your narrow lapels.
Thank you.
Well, those things will come back. Don't worry about it.
Welcome to Mr. Blackwell's hour.
Mr. Who?
Now, listen.
Blackwell.
Now, cut that out. While you're applauding, let's say hello to Jennifer Wilkins and Beverly Vendemilia here.
Hello.
Hello there, ladies. Beverly is our current champ. She's won one game. She has $350 in cash, right? And Jennifer is challenging her. We finished one round, haven't we, Jennifer?
Right.
And you haven't scored anything yet. She scored twice in round one.
Right.
And then we'll go to round two right after we go to this. So we're all ready here. Okay, here we go with round two. You ready, ladies?
Right.
I push the button and expose the two questions and ask our challenger to make a selection.
A.
A is what she wants. Now, you must match two celebrities here to stay in the game. Jennifer, here we go. Everyone plays.
Gotcha.
Harry the Lion Tamer lost his blank. That's what it says here. Harry the Lion Tamer lost his blank.
Harry the Lion Tamer lost his...
I thought I read it pretty well.
Stop peeking, Dickie.
Okay. Now, everybody is ready, so we'll ask Jennifer Wilkins to respond to this. Harry the Lion Tamer lost his...
chair.
His chair. That's one of the things they use. Okay, chair. Her answer is chair. You must match two celebrities to achieve a tie and stay in the game. Stu, may we see your answer, please?
Well, I was thinking of something a bit more beneficial for Harry the Lion Tamer. I thought I'd get rid of his dandruff and his... head.
His head. Little accident there, eh?
Yes.
All right, Loretta, what do you say?
Yes, well, Stu and I have a match.
Lost his head.
Lost his head.
Okay, that doesn't help Jennifer much. Let's see if McLean will help her.
This being my first time on the show, I may have made a boo-boo because I wrote down he lost his blank.
No.
Lost his nerve.
So he says he lost his nerve, Jennifer. We still don't have a match for you. Got three to go down here. And Brett, we call on you. Chair is her answer.
Chair is her answer.
Right.
Well, it's not my answer. Whip was my answer.
Whip.
It goes
right
with the chair.
Now, you must match both Richard and Ann to stay in the game. Harry the Lion Tamer lost his what, Richard?
Well, of course, lion tamers are with circuses. They live in trailers. He lost his portable toilet, or as we say, head.
Oh, yeah. No match, and Beverly wins again. Congratulations. Would you step around, please, Beverly? Okay, here you are. Jennifer, it's been a pleasure meeting you and doing business with you. We wish you the very best of luck. We have a gift for you backstage, together with our thanks for being on Match Game 73. Jennifer, welcome. Well, Beverly, you've been here before, haven't you?
Right.
You know how this goes?
Yes.
Now, would you want to explain it to me?
Yes. I get to pick three people.
Oh, no. I'm only kidding. I'll explain it to everybody. Right. Here we go with the super match where you can win $5,000. And
maybe it would
we'll
be better if she did it.
We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Minute blank.
minute blank. Now, the answer given most often by that audience is worth $500 if you can match it, remember. Second most frequent response, $250. Third, $100. Now you may solicit three answers from celebrities here.
Stu.
Stu, how would you fill in this? Minute what? Minute blank.
Minute man.
Minute man is his answer. That's one for you, Beverly.
Next time I'll pick a harder word.
Anne, would you give her a response?
Minute rice.
Minute rice. The audience likes all the answers you're getting so far here, Beverly.
Richard.
Present. Oh.
Yes.
Minute steak.
Minute steak.
To eat with a minute rice.
Very good.
To go with a minute rice.
By the minute man.
Yes.
I'll be with you in a minute, though.
All right, so you've got Minute Man, Minute Steak, Minute Rice. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. What would you like to do?
Minute Rice.
Minute Rice, you think, is the big one up there. All right, Beverly, let's find out together. She's looking for Minute Rice. May we see the $100 response? Minute Rice it is! That was Ann's answer. Just for the heck of it, let's find out if Minute Steak and Minute Man are up there, too. May we see the $250 response? Minute Maid. Nobody said that. All right.
I thought we couldn't do commercials on this
That's,
show.
No, anything you think that audience said. All right, now let's see what the $500 response is. Minute Man is up there. Stu, that was your answer.
Way to go, babe.
Okay, Beverly, you've won the $100 here now, and that means you'll play for 10 times that amount, or $1,000. To collect the $1,000, you got to match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. Please pick a celebrity now.
Stu.
Okay, Stu, it's you.
It's nice to know I'm a celebrity.
You
anyway.
Are a celebrity. You are a celebrated person. You get ready to write. Beverly, you face me. I'll get the $1,000 question. This is it, Stu. Write your answer to this. Hair blank. That's H-A-I-R blank. Okay, Stu is ready. Now, Beverly, we ask for your response to this blank. Hair.
Peace.
Hair piece is what she says. All right, Stu, for $1,000, may we see your answer?
She look at my head and say hair piece?
I don't think it's anything personal. She just thought that was a good answer.
Well, I'm sorry about that because I have plenty of hair and my problem has always been tonic.
Hair tonic is... So hair piece, hair tonic, they're all good answers. You didn't win the $1,000, but you're up to $550 with the additional $100 you won for winning the game. You're still the champ. You're going to meet another player. Let's introduce that player right now. Here comes Bruce Jameson.
Yay!
Hello, Bruce.
Would you step up there, please, and say hello to Bruce, Beverly? I guess you know each other. Hi, Bruce.
Hi, I'm a very native. I'm a very nervous native Angelino.
Very nervous native Angelino. Would you like to hold my hand and calm down for a minute? Okay, he is shaking there.
I thought you said Ruth Jameson, and no. I got a terrible shot when you came.
No, under no circumstances would I refer to him as Ruth, I'll tell you that there.
You sure your name's not Ruth's son?
No, that's Bruce Jameson.
Bad.
What do you do for a living, Bruce, or did you tell
I'm an
us?
Employed engineer. And I'm married and have four children.
Okay, nice to have you with us. You know that you and Beverly will be answering questions, trying to match our six celebrities. The one who has done that most often at the end of the second round wins and has a chance at the super match where you can win over $5,000. All
great.
Set to go? There we go. Bruce, would you make a selection?
Jane, I think I'll try A.
A is what he wants. New game. Everybody plays, folks. This is it. The old hen said to the young hen, are you listening?
Yes. I was just taking a peek at Loretta.
The old hen said to the young hen, that's not an egg you're sitting on, honey. That's a blank. Thinking about that? The old hen said that to the young hen. That's not an egg you're sitting on, honey. That's a blank.
And I want you to know I'm offended by that question.
Really?
I'm not.
I've met in a long time.
I'm not.
I'm finished. We can go on with the game now.
All right. As soon as we get answers from the others, we'll call on Bruce for his response. Everybody's ready. Bruce, so what do you think the old hen said to the young hen? That's not an egg you're sitting on, honey. That's a...
This time of the year, I guess it could be a baseball.
A baseball. Okay. He says a baseball. Stu, that's the answer he's looking for to match you. What do you say?
Well, we had the same idea. I wrote down, oh, yes, I did, golf ball.
Golf ball.
Yes.
Another good answer. Okay, Loretta, what do you say?
That's not an egg you're sitting on. That's a rooster. She was really confused.
Okay. No further explanations are in order there. What do you say, sir?
I could identify just for a moment, if I may, take about 5 minutes to do it.
Sure.
Bruce, being nervous, when you first called on me, I talked into my pen. thinking it was the microphone. Isn't that something, Bruce? Yeah.
I think it's something.
Wait till he tries to write with his microphone.
That's it.
I love the way Bruce told you everything before you even asked him. Okay.
And who asked you?
I looked down the stone. Not funny, but... Nice.
That's not an egg you're sitting on, honey. That's a stone. Okay, that's his answer.
Well, if
you don't have a match yet, Bruce. Let's see what we get here.
If anybody here has been raised in the country, they would know what a laying hen is. A laying hen is that no longer can lay eggs. But they go, and they do that a lot. So you get them a white doorknob, and that is a true thing. You've just gotten a piece of information.
That's what they do for poor hens that...
have given up laying.
A simple answer to the question is all we ask.
Right, sir.
Yes.
No colloquies of any kind.
That is not an egg you're sitting on. That is an eight ball.
That's an eight ball.
Hence the expression behind the...
All right, sorry. We got it right. He's still looking for a baseball, Ann. What are you offering?
I'm also looking for a baseball, but unfortunately, the young hen was out looking for action, so he was sitting on a chick.
Okay.
Could have been any of us.
So, you didn't score at all with that. Bruce and Beverly will get to your half of the round, but first we've got to get to this, so don't go away. All right, here we go with the second half of round one. Beverly, your question. Howard's tongue was so long, it got in the way every time he tried to blank. Think about that. Howard's tongue was so long, it got in the way every time he tried to blank. Don't talk into your pen, because it'll talk back to you.
I'm afraid.
Just trust your first instinct. That is usually the best one to match these people who are trying to win some money over here.
You sure you want me to trust my first instinct?
Okay, now we are ready, Beverly, to get a response from you. Howard's tongue was so long, it got in the way every time he tried to...
Kiss.
Boy, that's some answer there. Yes. Stu, what did you say?
The only possible thing that I could think of that I would have any difficulty doing with my tongue hanging out was shaving.
Shaving.
Well, how often do you shave your tongue, Stu?
You don't shave your tongue very often, except when it feels fuzzy in the morning after the night before there. Okay.
Well, I mean, try shaving around your tongue sometime. You've only got your lip there, and you don't make it now. You've got stuff hanging all down.
Well,
if your tongue was hanging out, you'd have a beard longer than his.
That's
check, waiter, please.
That's enough. Loretta, what did you say? Kiss is his, her answer.
Well, I took you at your word, and it was really a long, long tongue, so I said he had trouble tying his shoelaces.
That's a mind-boggling answer. McLean?
Now that you've got her mind.
I put down, I think, yeah, spit.
Every time. He did. Oh, boy.
Uh-huh. Howard's tongue was so long it got in the way every time he tried to kiss, is her answer. Brett, what's yours?
I think Uranus must be in reverse or something. People are acting very peculiar today. I said kiss, and if nobody can read that, it says kiss somebody.
Kiss is a match there. Well, there you go. There's one match for you, Beverly.
Brett, you're in.
Kiss. Richard, what did you say?
Kiss. It was an excellent answer, but the tongue got in the way every time he tried to whistle. Now, try it. Put your tongue out and go.
It's impossible to do.
Can't do it. Yeah.
Give us a kiss.
And kiss is the answer we're looking for.
Yes, and I know Howard Cosell very well. So I know he's always had a lot of trouble with his smooch.
Smooch and a kiss. How about that? That's a match, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yes, it is. He scored twice with that, Beverly. So at the end of round one, the score is 2-0 in favor of our current champion, Beverly Ventimiglia. Ventimiglia, I love your name.
Thank you.
Bruce, would you make a selection, if you please?
I think I'll try B this time.
B. Now, you must match two celebrities to achieve a tie and stay in the game. Here it is. Everyone participates. Dr. Welby said, "Nobody knows this, but I always blank before I operate." Don't look so astounded. You're in show business. Did you hear that clearly? Dr. Welby said, "Nobody knows this, but I always blank before I operate."
No.
You're changing your mind, I take it?
Yes.
Okay. We're waiting on you, sir.
I don't spell well.
Well, spelling doesn't count. Just give us a clue as to what it is, and you have, and that's it. And now, Bruce, we call on you for your response. Nobody knows this, but I always blank before I operate. What did Dr. Welby say?
Moment of truth. I think he takes a drink.
He takes a drink.
Yeah.
Takes a drink. You like that answer? All right, there's his answer to match our celebrities. Takes a drink. Stu, what did you say?
Well, I have been watching the show quite a long time, and I have never seen the doctor, Marcus Welby, operate. He has always given it to a specialist, so I figure if he ever had to operate, he would probably sweat first.
He would sweat first. All right, Loretta, what did you say?
No, Robert Young, who plays Dr. Welby, kisses Elena Verdugo before each operation.
He kisses for good luck.
That's
I
right.
I see. Okay.
He used to kiss Jim Brolin, you know.
But not you.
I nearly wrote that.
Okay. McLean, what did you say,
Dr. Welby? I couldn't come up with anything too good, so I put either calls his agent or spits.
Yeah, we were spitting, got a laugh.
He has
last
this thing about spitting.
Again.
Did you write a new card, or is that the same one?
No, I dropped it down through
the hole. Oh, you did? Yep. Okay. Dr. Welby said, "Nobody knows this, but I always blank before I operate." Brett, what does he do there?
To think we could have gone by boat. All right, I said, wash up. I am the only sensible person on this panel.
All right, now...
And I want applause for that.
Okay, for being a sensible lady, there's a brisk round of applause.
I've always said the breath was washed up.
We must get a couple of drinks from both Richard and Ann to keep you in the running here. Let's see what Richard
has. Unless he drinks the water that he washes in, that's the only way he would.
So, that's not a match, and Beverly wins another game. Congratulations, Beverly. Around you go. So you've got another $100, and we congratulate you, and we thank Bruce for being with us. We've got a gift for you backstage, Bruce, together with our thanks for being on Match Game 73.
Thank
Bruce
you
Jameson.
Much.
Now, you're going to have another go at the Super Match, and we're going to do that right after we do this. Here we go. Beverly Ventimiglia has been here before. You know how the Super Match goes, so let's begin. We polled a recent studio audience, got their best response to this. Blank hose. Now, you know 500 for the most frequent, 250 and 100. Three answers from the celebrities, so choose one of them at a time.
I'm sorry. Brett,
rubber hose.
Rubber hose, yes, is what Brett Summers says. Another celebrity?
Richard.
Silk hose.
Silk hose, you're such
an
old-fashioned. Okay.
Ann.
Ann.
Pantyhose.
Pantyhose. Okay, you got rubber hose, silk hose, and pantyhose. Now you can choose one of those or give us one of your own. What would you like to do?
Pantyhose.
Pantyhose. Okay, we're looking for pantyhose. May we see the $100 response? Garden hose. Not there. Still looking for pantyhose. Here is the $250 response. Fire hose. Here's your third and last chance, Beverly. Looking for pantyhose. Here is the $500 response. Yay! Okay! Congratulations to you. We'll get back to you right after we do this. Hope you'll join us next time when we'll find out if Beverly Ventimiglia will win the $5,000 in the second half of the Supermatch. You were super. You were terrific. Thank you all. Gene Rayburn saying so long for Match Game 73.
Today's consolation prizes are legs. Super stretching, super fitting pantyhose made to fit your legs. No bags, no sags. Legs hug you, hold you, never let you go. And a supply of Adolph's Instant Meat Tenderizer. Helps make meat tender, juicy, and delicious. Any cut of meat can taste even better with Adolph's, the original meat tenderizer. And a timely gift from Westclock. 17-jewel man's calendar wristwatch, water-resistant case, and radial brush dial from Westclock's Italian Industries Company. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.